My showreel. I hope it does impress you. As you can see, I'm a little bit busy, so I'm going to get back to it. Have a look.
Latest sports update with Pashka Mudlia, of course, the star of the show, Ngidi Ngidi Ngidi. That's a soundtrack I'm working on. Give me
That's
time.
That's a very good
Give
one.
Give me time. Yeah?
Very good one. Very good one. It's a reference from the 80s somewhere. But yeah, of course.
You're revealing my youth.
Lungi Ngidi, very, very successful today. So that's what I'm going to go straight to now. Lungi Ngidi took 6 wickets on debut to lead the Proteas to an impressive 135-run victory against India. Desiree Ellis has been appointed Banyana Banyana coach on a permanent basis. The South African Football Association confirmed the appointment on Thursday. Now Ellis, who has been Banyana Banyana's interim coach for almost 2 years, will now lead the team permanently. The former Banyana Banyana skipper has done fairly well in her capacity as the interim coach, having guided Banyana to the 2017 COSAFA title. Ellis will now be tasked with leading Banyana to qualify for the FIFA World Cup and the AFCON Women's Nations Cup. Now the 54-year-old replaced mentor Vera Powell.
The sports update, Pashka Mudlia is in studio. Good evening to you and thanks for joining us. And of course the cricket has been consuming a lot of our attention. And South Africa, what does it look like? A whitewash or not? Am I pushing it?
Well, you know what? I don't want to say anything. I don't want to offend too many people because there's certain sides to the story. But I can certainly say South Africa is in a strong position, and that's where I'm going to go to now. The Proteas in India are battling it out in a compelling test match at SuperSport Park in Centurion. Now South Africa resumed on 90 for 2 with AB de Villiers and Dean Elgar at the crease. Well, that's it from me and the sports desk, Cindy. As you can see, there was a whole mixture, a bag of things.
I mean you pulled out all the tricks. Absolutely, I appreciate it. That's award-winning stuff right there.
Well, let's hope so. Award-winning being hopefully tomorrow the Proteas can pull it off.
And of course a New Year's resolution that you'll bag the Vodacoms and everything. That's what I profess and I decree into your life.
Today I'm joined with Kanu, legendary Arsenal footballer. Give us a little insight as to what this means to you as a footballer giving back.
It means a lot, especially we, the former players. A lot of people look up to us and we don't want to disappoint them.
From an Indian perspective, obviously their side is going through some change as well with Virat Kohli.
If India lose, they mourn. So there's huge pressure on the players, on the officials to win.
Is transformation as we see it achievable in rugby? And obviously in light of the academy and things that that Sara is trying to do, is it achievable?
I think one of the big things we need to do in the next couple of years is to ensure that our public schools play sport.
This year, one of the highlights was Zulani Tete breaking the world record and knocking out his opponent. Can you take me through the mindset of throwing that punch, or was it just instinctive?
Actually the punch was planned.
What inspires you at this point? When do you consider yourself being the guy that's at the top looking down? And if so, how do you get that extra verb to go beyond?
Yeah, no, not at all. I really still see myself at the bottom looking up, trying to continue achieving so much more.
There's a certain kind of ethos that the Box have in their team setup, and I'm saying that in reflection with obviously Bafana and the situation right now.
I think you've got a point. There is a certain DNA that is part and parcel of a Springbok setup.
We here at ANN are now taking to the skies to show you where all the people of the country are voting. It's vitally important to have a bird's eye view of where the country is going to cast their vote. Now joining me to talk a little bit about the Rio successes is one of the men that actually brought home a medal. Sean, thank you for taking the time to join us and speak to us. Rowing has been on an upward trend in South Africa. Our rowers seem to be doing well, and of course you guys brought home the silver. How does it feel to be wearing that?
Oh, thanks, Paj. It's a pleasure to be here. It's an amazing feeling to be wearing this thing. It's been a lot of years of hard work and dedication to get it, so I'm just very, very happy and relieved to have finally got it.
For most South Africans, the supplement industry simply means that you're taking a supplement to get more exercise, to be more fit. But the reality is all that more different, and it's a deep and dark hole. Here's hoping that Kyalami can once again rise from the ashes and be the place where motorists come to. But first, they'll have to cross the checkered line and hope that everything is ready come September.
1995 saw Nelson Mandela unify a nation behind a very symbol of oppression, the Springbok emblem. And of course, we won that World Cup and it was seen as a unification of mind, body and soul. But now what we see in the US is an opportunity for athletes of color to protest against their current leader. But the question remains, should a protest be done while singing the national anthem?
The reality of spot fixing and match fixing is that it affects every single game at every single minute at every single time. And the reality of that is that whatever we are watching might not necessarily be the right outcome just for the game.
Ah, you're back. I do hope you enjoyed my showreel and perhaps that it does impress you. But for me, it's ciao for now. Until later.